guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm sitting in the exact same location as last time. Let me just fix this a little bit. I guess it's good. I mean, let me know in the comments down below. This is just where it works for now. So anyways, welcome back to my channel. I'm a little bit out of breath. I'm so thirsty, so ignore me if I need to take multiple drinks throughout because I'm just so, like, I have unquenchable thirst. It's insane. Anyways, today's video, I wanted to sit back down again. I have like some vlog footage that I was like, should I just put up a vlog? But then I was like, no, I kind of want to put up a story time. And a lot of you guys asked for my story time of how I found out I was pregnant. So yeah, this is what that video is going to be. So I feel like this is kind of a weird and fun video, and I don't know, I find it kind of funny, and I've told a lot of people and they're like, oh my god, that's funny, but maybe it's not that funny. Regardless, I'm going to tell you anyways. So basically, I am like on this Saturday, so it's Monday, I'm just 19 weeks and a couple days pregnant. So I found out in August, right before, I was supposed to move on August 16th. That was supposed to be my last day of work and the day I was supposed to leave. So my boyfriend was coming in the Friday, the 16th, which I believe, I think it's the 16th. Someday on the Friday in the middle of August. Anyways, he was supposed to come and he was gonna help me just drive our trailer from California to Dallas. That was supposed to be what it was, because I was just gonna get rid of everything and buy all new when we got here. He has a lot of stuff, but we were just gonna buy pieces together instead of like bringing all my old crap, because it just like was not worth it. It was stuff from like from college. Like a dog hair on my camera. So that was the plan. So I was just gonna load up a little U-Haul trailer, like a medium-sized one, and trailer it across. So he was gonna help me because it's a really long drive and I had Winnie too, so that was the plan. Because when I originally moved to Dallas, I spent like over $4,000 probably to move. I had my car moved and I had a pod moved. So really expensive, just not the way I wanted to do it this time. So decided that way. So I had been deciding, we had decided that I was gonna move probably like finalize in the beginning of July. And then we went on a trip in the middle of July and it just kind of sealed the deal. Like, yeah, this is the right decision. But I had made that decision. So I started packing pretty much at the beginning of July. I started just slowly packing stuff up, slowly weeding things out. I'm a very big like planner in that sense. Like I like to start ahead of time, so I feel like I'm in control of that. And it gives me this feeling of, I can't control all the stresses in the world, but I can control the stress that I can control. Does that make sense? Probably not, but whatever. I knew I could control the fact that I had to pack all this stuff up and how I was gonna do it. So I kind of like planned that all out, and that was just like how I dealt with stress. So yeah, so I'd already like really started packing, and by the time August came around, I was pretty much fully packed. I still had, I had done all the math on like what was gonna fit in the trailer and yada yada. This is a very long backstory. Anyways, everything was ready to go. But that Friday before, I was supposed to get my period in the beginning of August. So within that like first week, but I figured, hey, I'm stressed. Like who knows? Like I'm beyond stressed. Like you just never know, right? So I was like waiting and waiting. And the Friday before I was supposed to move, the week before I was supposed to move, there was a day, I think it was like Thursday or something, I felt really off, just like really off, like I was hungover, but I wasn't hungover. Like I had been drinking and I felt like hot sweats and like, or cold sweats, I don't know what that term is, but you know what I mean. I just felt like the back of my neck was so hot, like I needed to sit down, like I was just so winded, and I felt nauseous. That was that, and I had some pretty decent cravings. Like I remember craving Chipotle, and I hadn't had Chipotle in years, and different things like that. And so whatever, the week went by and I was like, okay, it's fine. You know, the same pregnancy symptoms are the same as getting your period. So it's kind of weird. And also I was like, you know, like I didn't think it would happen that quick. I'm just gonna be honest with you. I just didn't know. It only takes one time, so there's that. But but anyway, so the Friday before I was supposed to go out, it was my last weekend out. I was supposed to go out with my like friends, but I, was it that Friday? Yeah, it was the Friday before I was moving. So 2 weeks, or a week before I was supposed to be moving, right? Okay, got it. I just felt like I was supposed to go out with two of my girlfriends because we went out the weekend before, and yeah, and I was like supposed to go out with them. It was supposed to be like my last hurrah because I wasn't gonna have next weekend. And so everything I was like, and I had plans for that Sunday as well to go out with some coworkers too. But anyway, so Friday night is like approaching. I got done with work and I felt shitty all day. And I start just like feeling like, oh, I just don't feel good. And I'm like, maybe I'm pregnant. Like maybe I really truly am. I have no idea, right? So I'm sitting and I'm thinking, and my boyfriend is out because it's his last like weekend with the boys before he has to come get me. And like, you know, we're gonna be unpacking for like a week or like a couple weekends, and it's just gonna kind of be chaos. So he wanted to go out with his friends one more time. Like, not like one more time, you know what I mean? Just like go out with the boys. So anyways, he was going out that night and he's like 2 hours ahead of me when I'm in California. So it's like 7 o'clock at night. And I'm off at work, I'm off work and I'm settled in and I'm like still feeling like I've got pain in my left ovary. I feel nauseous, not like super nauseous, just, I just don't feel good. So I start watching symptoms videos, like the first 2 weeks symptoms where people are saying like what they are and how they're feeling before they knew they were pregnant. I didn't take a test, I didn't know. I just went down this rabbit hole of like, what do you feel when you feel like you're gonna be pregnant? And it lined up directly. And there's a part of me that obviously must have known to like check that. I have never once in my life, let me tell you, had a pregnancy scare. Not once. I've been on birth control since I was like 15 years old. I have not once had a pregnancy scare, so I had no idea what I was dealing with, right? I'm sure a lot of people have had a pregnancy scare in their life. For me, I just never have. And so it was all new to me, but I started going down this rabbit hole of that, and I found a lot of videos and a lot of knowledge. And I started telling my boyfriend, and I was like, you know, like maybe. And he was just like, I don't know, like I think it's coming. You're probably just stressed. Like it is what it is. Just kind of like blowing it off, right? Not making a big deal about it. But he's like, but if you want to, just get a test and take a test, right? And so I was like, that Friday, I was like, you know, I decided I wasn't gonna go out. Like I was like, you know, I'm just like not going to because there's just something in that me that tells me I shouldn't go. But I also didn't want to go get a test. So I decided, the reason being, because I lived in a super small town in Newport, like not a small town, but like a small little area. And there was a Rite Aid right down the street, like walking distance. And I went there like all the time. And I knew the guy who worked there because he's the old guy and he always works there. And he's always there. And I didn't want to like go in and like get a pregnancy test and like put it on the counter. I didn't even know where the pregnancy tests were. I have no idea because I am like that cut off of the world of that, because like I said, since till up until February of that year, I had been on birth control. And so I didn't even, it didn't even like, I don't know, nothing like that ever fazed me. And I never had to worry about it. So I'm like, I'm not going to that Rite Aid because I don't want that guy to think I'm a floozy, right? I don't know. That was my mindset. I'm like, no, he can't see me. He thinks I'm a sweet, innocent girl who comes and buys body wash and razors, and I'm not hoeing it up, okay? So I was like, I'm not gonna do it. I'm gonna Amazon it, right? Who doesn't love Amazon Prime? So I'm like, okay, I don't work tomorrow. I can take the test tomorrow. I'll Prime it tonight, and I'll get it by tomorrow. It's not a big deal. I just won't go out tonight. I'm okay with not knowing the results. I'll keep watching this rabbit hole of YouTube and just be done, eat my feelings, cry. Who knows? Whatever I was going through. So I order Prime it, and then I'm like sitting in bed and I'm watching more of these videos and I'm like, no. All of a sudden I start craving Hot Pockets. And if you know me, you know that I eat pretty clean, pretty healthy. Like I, before pregnancy, was pretty much just sticking to like a plant-based diet. I didn't eat dairy. I would eat fish occasionally when I was like out and stuff like that, but mostly tofu, plant-based diet. Like I was pretty strict on it. And I started craving Hot Pockets, not just one. I wanted the pizza and I wanted the ham and cheese. And I wanted to heat them up at the same time so I could eat one, like bite it so it would cool, and eat the other, you know, it was a whole thing. And so I was like, okay, well, it was like, at that time it was like 9:30. And I was like, okay, well, I could walk to the grocery store that's right on the corner, or I could just go to Walmart and get a pregnancy test and get my Hot Pockets. So I Googled the nearest Walmart, which is like probably 20 minutes away. It wasn't close, but I was like, okay, whatever, I'll just go. So I built up the courage. I put Winnie in the car. We're on our way to go to Walmart to get this pregnancy test and my Hot Pockets, of course, my Hot Pockets. That was number one on my list. And so I was in like leggings and a sweatshirt, and I had Birkenstocks on, my hair was in a bun. I was probably crying, not like crying, like sad crying, just like emotional, like I have no idea what I'm doing. Why is this my life sort of crying? How have I gotten to this point sort of crying? And so we get to Walmart, and I actually feel like I vlogged that moment. And if I can find it and it's not like insanely bad quality and insanely embarrassing, I'll put it in. If I can't, just know it was terrible. So anyways, I get into Walmart. First things first, I go straight for the Hot Pockets. Go to the frozen section, get my Hot Pockets. I'm super amped. Like, I haven't had Hot Pockets in so long. So I was at, then I'm like, got my Hot Pockets in my hand, because I'm like, okay, I can use my Hot Pockets to cover up the pregnancy test so that people aren't just seeing me walk around with a pregnancy test. I'm not sure why I'm this psycho, but I just am, okay? So I walk over to the, you know, the, what do you call it, pharmacy area. And I'm like looking for the pregnancy test, can't find them, walking down every aisle. Mind you, this is the busiest Walmart at 9:30 at night on a freaking Friday I've ever been to. I was like, oh my God, just like kids running everywhere. And I'm just like, don't look at me, ignore me, probably no one was. Anyway, so I find the pregnancy test, and needless to say, they are locked behind glass like doors with a lock on it, and there's a button next to it that says need assistance, press for whatever it is. So I press it. I'm waiting for a while, I don't see anybody. I walk to the other aisle, March. I don't stand in front of that little glass container because I'm already insanely like whatever, and there are people all down the aisles looking for, you know, Tylenol, normal things, and I'm over here, you know, whatever. And so standing here with my Hot Pockets. So I'm like, okay, so I walk to the next little aisle and I'm just kind of like peeking around, waiting for someone to come up with a vest. I figured I would see them, right? And so these two people will come in with a vest, come up with a vest, and I'm like, oh, are you here to unlock? And they're like, oh, no, 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 but somebody's coming. And I'm like, okay, okay. Okay. So I'm like, great. And so I'm like, I walk back and I'm just kind of like hanging out near it or whatever. And so the guy comes and he's like, what do you want? What do you need? Like it's some sort of drug deal or something. Like there's like guns behind this. And I'm like, I'll take the AK-40. No. So I'm like, I'll take the digital clear blue test. And he's like, okay. And so, or I said, I'll take a pregnancy test. And then I was, and then he was like, which one? And I was like, I had no idea there were that many pregnancy tests. So I was like, real quick. I was like looking for a digital one. And I was looking for multiple because I didn't want just one, right? It's because I've read that you need to take multiple. Okay. You can get false positives. So I'm like, okay, a 3-pack of clear blue digital. Okay, that one. And then I was like waiting for him. I have my hand out, my Hot Pockets. And he's like, oh no, 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 I can't give it to you. Like you have to go up to register for it. I'll be sitting there waiting for you. Just tell them that it's yours. And I'm like, okay, a whole another layer of awkwardness. So then I have to just kind of like mosey around a little bit, waiting for this guy to walk up to register for and put my stuff down. And so I'm like, okay. So thankfully I get to register for, and there's a line in front of me. It's not like super packed behind me, but it's the cigarette line. So it's the line that you know people are gonna come to because they're trying to buy cigarettes and like lottery tickets or whatever. I don't know what they sell there, but it's the line that everyone has to have their stuff held for, right? Because apparently people are trying to steal pregnancy tests. I guess if you're trying to steal it, there's probably a reason, but whatever. So anyways, I get up to the counter, I put my Hot Pockets on the thing, and then now at this point, there's a line of like 4 people behind me, okay? Dudes, whatever, you know, totally loving it. Just a girl in her sweatpants and sweatshirt on a Friday night with Hot Pockets. That's all they think of me at this point, right? Until I get up to the register and I'm like, I have that, that's mine, that's on hold as well for me to purchase. And she's like, oh, this video game? And I'm like, no ma'am, that. And she was like, oh, you mean this pack of razors? And I was like, no. And she's like, oh, the pregnancy test. And I'm like, heart sunk. I'm just like, fuck. And I'm thinking, this lady's probably looking at my Hot Pockets, looking at my pregnancy test. She's like, girl, you do not need this pregnancy test. Clearly you're pregnant, you're eating Hot Pockets, okay? Not just one flavor, two flavors. And you're probably gonna eat them all tonight. And I did. So that was mortifying. I just put in my card, we did the whole thing, and I had to pay for the bag because I forgot to bring my bag because, you know, California. So anyways, I got it. I got everything I needed. I get to the car. I'm like mortified that that even happened to me and that is my life, but whatever. We get home. And so like I'm research after all of my researching on this 2 week symptoms, I hadn't even researched like when's the best time to take a pregnancy test. And it turns out the best time is in the morning. So I'm like, cool. So I got this thing and I can't even take it right now. Anyways, so I'm going to, because they say like the highest levels of your, it's not THC, I don't know why I wanted to call it that, but whatever, it's some sort of level of hormonal whatever that your body's producing now that you're pregnant, right? And so they say the highest levels in the morning. They also say if you try to drink right before it, you're gonna dilute your pee and then blah, blah, blah. So I was like, okay, well, whatever. So I grab my LaCroix because health and my two Hot Pockets, and I'm like eating them interchangeably so I can chow them down as quick as possible. And if you like hack, my best friend taught me how to do this, if you like cut around the outsides of them and like lay them open, let them cool for a while, put them back together, put them in the thing, you can eat them a whole lot quicker. Anyways, just a pro tip for you. I craved so many Hot Pockets during the beginning of my pregnancy. I probably ate like 6, and that doesn't sound like a lot, but it's a lot for me because I don't eat that crap. Anyways, so I'm eating my Hot Pockets, I'm drinking my LaCroix, and I'm like watching my videos, crying, thinking, wow, not only am I pregnant, I'm gonna be the most unhealthy pregnant lady in the world. Still thinking, I'm probably not pregnant. I'm probably just crazy, and my period will come tonight, right? I'll probably get my period the minute I'm like peeing out of the stick. It'll like, you know, whatever. Anyways, so I'm drinking and I'm eating and watching my videos, and then all of a sudden I'm like, I have to pee. Should I just take the test? I mean, they say to take it best in the morning, but whatever, it's gonna be a false anyway, so it'll be a false negative or whatever. I'll just take it again in the morning. I've got 3. I might as well just try tonight. Like maybe I'll be able to sleep if I pee and it's not positive, right? So this whole time, I told my boyfriend I was going to get the test and that I was going to get Hot Pockets and blah, blah, blah. And he's out with his friends, hanging out, whatever, but texting me back. And so I told him, I was like, I'm just gonna do it. I'm gonna take it. And he's like, okay, well, let me know how it goes. It's gonna be no big deal. Don't stress out. And I'm over here like, okay, I'm totally stressing out. So I take me and Winnie, we go into the bathroom, we lock the door because God forbid, who knows, I just can't have anyone knowing what I'm doing because I'm just crazy. So I'm like, okay, I've never done this before, so I'm thoroughly reading the instructions to make sure I don't mess this up. And so I go and I pee on the dang stick, okay? There we go. And so I do it and then I put it on the edge of my sink, and from the time it took me to put it on the edge of the sink, which I thought this process was like 2 minutes, I go down to pick up Winnie because I'm like, girl, I need some emotional support. I go down and pick up Winnie and I scoop her up in my arms and we come back up to the sink and we look at the test and it's pregnant. And I'm like, what? Like, that's not possible. There, like, everything I read said that you're always gonna have false positives in the beginning or false negatives in the beginning and all of these things. I'm like, how? How is the first test that I ever take positive? And I like don't think I dropped Winnie, but I politely set her down on the floor, and then I collapsed to the floor and I cried. I cried so hard. And from the minute I texted my boyfriend I'm taking the test to like 30, not even 30 seconds later, I called him and he answered, and I was bawling. So obviously he knew at that moment. I don't want to sound like this is something I wanted to be a mother for so long, and I don't ever want it to sound like I regret having my child. But at that moment, I realized, and I think anyone realizes this, whether it's planned or not, you realize in that moment that your life is never going to be the same again. And that, when you've lived the same life, selfishly, for 29 years, is really hard to take. And if you're alone, and you're already super emotional, right? Because you're pregnant, and for me, I was alone, and I was moving, and I was all this craziness, right? It was a lot. and I had a full on meltdown, and I did. And poor Scott, because I called him, and he was at the bar, probably drinking, probably pretty drunk with his friends, and he stepped out and he talked to me for hours on the phone, consoling me, and yeah, it was pretty rough, I'm not gonna lie. And I could not believe it, and I thought, when am I gonna wake up from this dream? There's no way this is happening to me. I am nowhere near ready. I just quit my job and I'm moving across the country. What? Like, horrible timing, Kelly, horrible timing. And I just kept saying, I didn't think it could happen. I didn't think, and I'm thinking, wow, good thing you were on birth control at 15 years old, or your ass would have had a baby at like 16. But anyways, that's my story. So needless to say, he handled it really well, was so freaking supportive. He did have a little bit of a freak out moment the next day. I think it really hit him where he was like, oh, hell, what are we gonna do? Not what are we gonna do, but just, it was a lot. Like, we were, you know, we had just got back together in a relationship. We had just decided to move back, and I'm like, hey, and here's a baby. I come with baggage, right? I not only come with a dog, I come with a big fat belly, and soon we will have a baby. So it was a little bit for him, but he was definitely really supportive, and it ended up being totally okay. The next morning, I think I stayed up till like 3 a.m. and he stayed up all night talking to me. And then the next morning, I set my alarm to call my mom, and she was out to breakfast with some friends, and that was the first person I told. I was just like, this is how I told my mom, so if you need some advice. I was like, what I'm about to tell you, your reaction to what I'm about to tell you is going to really affect me. So just know that. And then I told her, and she's so supportive. She's amazing. Like, honestly, I've had kind of an on-off relationship with my mom. Just because of my parents got a divorce not that long. Well, it was like 10 years ago. It was like 10 years ago, Kelly. No, I don't know. It was a long time ago, but it's still really hard for me. And I don't live in New York all the time, so I don't see it. It's just still really hard for me. And I went back and forth, but I knew she was the first person that I wanted to tell, and I knew she would support me, and I knew she would be there for me, and I needed her. So anyways, she was everything in that and everything and more. But that is how I found out I was pregnant story. I don't know if that's really funny, but to me it kind of is, because it's kind of comical, and I guess I have to laugh at it, but yeah. Now I can look back and laugh at it, because I am just like, I mean, that was so long ago at this point. It just feels so long ago. And now that I've seen his little teeny tiny hands and his little feet, and he crosses his little legs, and I'm having a boy, by the way. it's just kind of crazy. And I think that no matter where you are in your life, you'll never be perfectly prepared, and you'll never be ready 100%. Could I have been more ready? Yes. But my boss told me, when I told my boss something, and I just remembered it just really stuck out to me. She goes, you know, she had a baby really young. And she said, you know, a lot of my friends who are older, who waited to think that they were ready financially and all this, now are too old and can't, or now are too old and are just stuck in a routine and don't. So it's like, there's no perfect time. And you can say that you wish that things were different, and it would be great if X, Y, and Z happened, but that's just not life. And that it is what it is. And I'm fortunate that, you know, no matter what, like, I knew that I would make it work, and it would work. So I hope you guys enjoyed my long story. This is a really long story time of how I found out I was pregnant, but I hope you guys found it funny a little bit. And I'm gonna continue with vlogs after this video, but I just wanted to put something up, and I thought story time would be kind of fun and appropriate for after that. I think that's pretty much where we're at. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.